Good morning, friends. We have to appreciate the efforts by two law students of Damodaram Sanjeevayya National Law University, Visakhapatnam, in filing a public interest litigation under Article 226 of the Constitution of India before the Honorable High Court of AP at Amaravati. Kudos to them. Actually, you have to appreciate in the stage of students itself, they are able to file a public interest litigation. You may be knowing the public interest litigation doesn't need any locus standi. So it is a non-locus standi principle. Anybody can file a public interest litigation provided there is some general public interest and there is no specific pro forma for that. But they have beautifully written the public interest litigation. So these students are by names Mr. Arun Tiwari and Keshav Baheti. Both of them filed the public interest litigation and yesterday it has come for hearing in court number 2 by Justices Rakesh Kumar and Suresh Reddy, and actually it is the first case for them and first case yesterday which have come up in the before the court. Right now they have mentioned about the Article 20 of the Constitution, a right to life and liberty. Their main plea is against the online classes and secondly the collection of fee by the university. These two things are they have been more emphasized, and the third one is regarding the complicated mental health condition of the students. Also they wanted to take care of by the High Court. Ultimately High Court has given directions in some other way. So we'll come to the at the last part of my lecture. Now let us understand or let us know what the public and contents of the public interest litigation they filed. So first they started like this. It is the duty and obligation of the university administration to look into the empathetic situation of each and every individual student. So they have to go to the ground realities. So they have to go to the economic, social and mental impact of the fee structure will be on the students. Because what happened is now, of course, with the COVID-19 pandemic, normally the classes are not being conducted. Therefore, the university wanted to start online classes. So for starting online classes, so they asked the students to come online. They will use the either Zoom app or Video app, whatever app they like. So they will give the so-called password to them and they have to attend. But they have emphasized the condition of the students, how the students are from, which background the students came. So there are so many people who are coming from the underprivileged backgrounds. Number one, most of them are minority. They belong to the minority communities. Second is economically weaker, EWS, economically weaker sections. And third one is, most of them are from the remote rural areas. For example, if you go to Adavulavivi or some other village, can you expect the internet to work there? It's not possible. So that's the main problem. No doubt, the government or the university is supposed to conduct the classes and they have to complete the syllabus. For that purpose, they may be asking the students to go for online classes, to attend the online classes, because simply physical coaching is not possible because of the COVID-19 pandemic and social distance may not be followed while being in the class, because the class are limited and 40 persons can't sit in a class now. So therefore, online class is better, but still they have to take into consideration all these aspects. So therefore, it should not be mandatory, should become optional. That is for the purpose they have filed this. So Keshav Baheti. And please remember, they have stated that these facilities, the students, they do not have sufficient means or basic infrastructure to attend the online classes or for appearing the online examinations also. Right. So conducting the online evaluation or online classes or any kind of assessments. So in the coming days, normally it suffers from the presumption that every student has the required basic infrastructure. Definitely there are so many different types of people. Normally they may not having the high speed internet facility because they come from far flung areas. So definitely you cannot unreasonably classify them together and take up the so called online classes. Therefore, it has been requested that the university may be directed to make it non-mandatory for the students to attend the online classes rather than making it compulsory. Right? One point. Second point is regarding the collection of fee. So they have sought appropriate orders for the cancellation of the examinations and also basing on the evaluation. They might have appeared for the internal examinations. Basing on that, they can, just like the 10th class examinations or some other universities, they have stated they wanted to pass all the students. That also can be assessed. Then third one is, even though we are in the COVID-19, the university is pressurizing them or asking them, forcing them to pay library fee, hostel fee, mess charges, internet fee, electricity charges, and all the even during the lockdown period. Actually, they are not utilized by them. These services are not availed by them, but still they have to pay the fee. This is another bolt, actually, this is a thunderbolt for them. So, in their view, the universities have turned into profit-making corporations where they charge a mandatory increment in the tuition. Every year they are increasing the tuition fee. So tuition fee for the year 20-21 should not be increased because of the COVID-19, because the parents, they are also not in a position to make both ends meet because of the COVID-19, because of the shutdown. Therefore, there should be no enhancement of the tuition fee. Therefore, they are asking for the grievances to be redressed by the High Court level. If the above reliefs are not given, the students will be put in a stage where they will be forced to reveal their private life. That means economic life, geographical means remote areas, and social life, because economic weak sections, because they do not have sufficient infrastructure to meet the deadlines of the university. So normally they don't want to leave their bag and other things, suppose, but if the university insists the fees, definitely they might have come forward. So therefore, they are stating that this is a violation of right to privacy enshrined in Article 21 of the Constitution of India. So therefore, they request the court, the university, or the court to give directions to the university not to collect the so-called extra fee for the that library, hostel, then mess charges and also electricity charges as internet, since they are not using them. Therefore, as the lockdown has severely affected them, regarding last point, mental health. So since it has affected the mental health, normally the university has a complementary role to remedy the same. So therefore, immediately, as far as the mental ill health students, for that the medical, there may be counseling by medical staff also. This is their request. So please remember, they have raised 4 points mainly. Number one, regarding the collection of fee, for which they have not availed actually mess charges all day, because once the COVID lockdown is there, they ask them to vacate. Now they are not staying in the hostels. Second point is tuition fee. Normally every year it is the habit of the college. Of course, they have also to survive. We cannot find fault of the universities also. So their increase in the so-called tuition fee may not be affected. At least it may be postponed for 1 year. Similarly, the crux is on the online classes. Online classes, no doubt, we should encourage them. Of course, the people in the towns, the people are in the cities, the people mandal level, they can attend. But what about the people, the students in the remote areas? Definitely, it is not possible for them. And lastly, regarding the getting through the examination, that is passing, of course it is for the university to decide. We cannot tell, because the internal examinations are not the actual criteria for making them pass the examination, because we have been seeing the internal exams how beautifully they write. And in my view, the exams should be there. No doubt the exams may be conducted taking many halls or online, whatever way they like. Online, these people are interested, not interested. Now ultimately, the Honorable High Court has directed these people to approach the competent authority first. So you have to approach the competent authority and seek remedy. If there is a failure, if the people, they do not look into your grievance, then you can come to the High Court, and we are there to give the guidelines. That is what Justices Rakesh Kumar and Suresh Reddy stated in the order. Anyway, immediately these students along with some others, they wanted to approach the Vice Chancellor of Sri Damodaram Sanjeevaya National Law University. Let us hope something good will be happening to them. Thank you.